He did say a lot
aren't here, though. Also, number 10 is number 6 and number 10.
Sides for this?
I mean, I can kind of see.
Up to you. I think you do have to lean over more on my side anyway for the neck corner, but that back.
Yeah, I still want to stay on the right side.
The door to go and get inside there was locked.
Really?
Yeah. That was awesome.
Also, I read, I forget where the head coach of Westminster last coached, but, like, he broke a record for roster size or something.
Really?
Which is kind of clear how it's carried over here. Like, this is just way too many for just a soccer team.
Yeah, that's a lot of guys.
Like, this could be a football team. Like,
they are a football team, lad. They're a football club.
Okay, so number 6 on Iowa Wesleyan is going number 10.
Okay, can I get an effort here
with
these?
Yeah, I want to take these down, though.
Chris Rimmer. Cesar Arroyo.
Not here.
Derek.
Yeah, the guy said he didn't know, but I'm going to say Atua Henny.
Atua Henny.
Yeah.
Julio Almedo.
Almedo.
Almedo. David Chavez.
David Chavez.
Christian Garcia. Xavier Lozada. Javier.
Javier Lozada.
Javier Lozada. Okay. Where? This is Javier?
Yeah.
Okay. Javier Lozada. Okay. Mariano Mateo Moreno.
I don't know if he's here.
Triple M's. Carlos Mateo Moreno. Pedro Pina.
Pina.
Richard Neves.
Yeah.
Giovanni
Pacheco.
Francisco Javier Saldana. Efrain Alvaldo.
Efrain
Alvaldo.
Alvaldo.
Jared Stone.
Thomas Caruda,
Ernesto Barrientos, Raul Garcia, Carlos Taylor,
Joao Vieira,
Ion.
Nope. Jaja.
No.
I literally said the guy, I was like, no, there's no way. He's like, I don't know, this is what we call him.
Jaja Ridout?
Right out.
I should know that one. Gian Andres, Franceschi, Satrasola. Okay. Christian Rios, Emiliano Batcher.
Batcher.
George Chappell.
George Chappell.
Chappell.
No, it's
Dave Chappell. Okay.
No, it's Chappell. Actually.
George Chappell.
Vicente Sanchez?
Sanchez.
Yeah, Sanchez.
Fabian Zamora. Ricardo Plata. And then Connor Wobe.
Wobby.
Parker Jett, Connor Benefield, Justin Jerdeman,
Gertiman,
Sam Heckert, Francois Mua, Joe Wilder, Reese Prophet,
yeah.
Matthew Schulte, Quinn Van Dyke,
Moose.
Moose Shun.
Shuna.
Oh my god, dude, this is ridiculous. Philip. Udinue.
Yeah.
Udinue. Patrick Wisniewski. I knew that one.
Yeah, Udinue.
Jordan Karloff.
Karhoff.
Joshua.
Gilliams, Ellinger, Lieberman, Sprengel.
Wow, this is both pages? Holy crap. Dude, you only need 11 guys.
For Westminster. I'm just not gonna say
it. We're just gonna go with it then.
God.
Thank you.
sun is setting behind overcast cap clouds here in Fulton, Missouri, Blue Jay Stadium at Keith and Judith Mueller Stadium, or Mueller Field, excuse me, for Westminster versus Iowa Wesleyan men's soccer here in the SLIAC Conference. Westminster has only played one game of the season last week against Fontbonnie. Loss to the away team, or excuse me, away at Fontbonne. Iowa Wesleyan currently 2-0, projected to finish top of the SLIAC as we kick off here in Fulton. Iowa Wesleyan wearing all purple tonight. Westminster in light blue tops, white shorts, light blue socks. Will Nolte alongside Connor McCann here. Prime commentary for both the men's and women's games today. The women's just finished 2-0 over Iowa Wesleyan here as possessions given up by Iowa Wesleyan right back to Westminster.
Yeah, after a great game that we saw in the first one, the women winning 2-0 after a dominating performance, we'll be interested to see if the men can follow up against a very, very tough Iowa Wesleyan squad.
And a Schrader on the throw in. Westminster, a very large roster size, they're going to take up the entire bench on the far side. Moving the ball well, have the ball inside Iowa Wesleyan territory here early. We'll be knocking around the back line. Wesleyan giving it right back with Saldana. Now out to David Chavez. He tries to switch the field. Defense being played. Chavez again trying to get it out wide left. So Lozada now. Javier Lozada trying to dance around with it. He'll seed it back to his teammate Stone. Jared Stone on the overlap. Here comes Stone on the far left side. Cross coming into the back post. Headed away off the line by Inoue. Joseph Inoue, to be exact, one of two, as they are twins. His brother Philip on the bench to start this one out. He is playing defense right now against the Tigers. Only 2 minutes into this one. And even so far in terms of possession, Inoue now trying to send in a ball down the left-hand flank. Looking for Patrick Wisniewski, he finds it. Wisniewski inside the box. Get a shot off and a great save right there to get the first quarter of the game.
Lightning fast start for both teams, both pushing the action. Both teams with a good chance so far. Wisniewski's just a little bit better, though. It looks like he'll have a corner, but it appears the goalkeeper for Wesleyan is still down. We had that issue at the end of the last game, and now this one's starting off with an injured goalkeeper as well.
Vicente Sanchez is a freshman goalkeeper from Valencia, Spain. Made a fantastic save on that last one. Still on the ground, just getting up right now as both trainers come out to meet him right on his goal line. Must be favoring about his right knee or so. As he pops off at 4:45, still left remaining just in the second minute of action here. Iowa Wesleyan comes into this matchup with nearly entirely international players. Sanchez is one of them, coming from Spain as a freshman. On the corner now for Westminster. First one of the game. First opportunity on a set piece for the Blue Jays. Played to the front post. No Blue Jay was there to meet it. Cleared off the line very easily. Coming out to meet it. Meet it though for the Blue Jays down the left hand flank. I believe that's Murray trying to get it in. Another quarter now for Westminster coming up. Two in only just about 30 seconds.
They're really pushing the pace to start it off. This is a team in Iowa Wesleyan that won 10-0 in their last matchup. So a team that can score a lot of goals. The more you're able to keep the ball on their end of the field instead of yours, the more better shape you'll be in.
They beat Eureka 10-0, as you said, on Saturday. I've also played Fontbonne as well. They've won 2-1 in extra time. The Blue Jays only losing to Fontbonne 1-0, coming out for goal in about the 84th minute. This goal is played into the front post as well. Stoppage and play called. I believe it's going to be offside on the short corner kick between the two. They just played it back to the team. I couldn't tell exactly who it was down there on the goal line. And great play by Iowa Wesleyan to get their players up off that line to catch them offside. Tigers back line now. Garcia right now, Raul Garcia. And step back, moving ball out to his left. Down the left-hand flank now. Trying to go is Lozada. With a nice little flick, a big reaction from somewhat of a crowd we have here in their lawn chairs. This is Christian Rios, who is trying to play defense now, but tackled him out of bounds. They played by Wisniewski. Here comes a throw in now for Iowa Wesley. Olmedo. Took the interception there to get it right back. Westminster having it with Gertyman. Playing over the top now. Trying to run onto his Wisniewski. Sanchez is right there to collect it into his arms and distribute it out to his left. Christian Garcia now for the Tigers. Out to Stone. Stone played it up top now. Pacheco trying to dump it in behind, looking for David Chavez to run onto it. Also coming out to meet it was Chase Vogt. Senior 6'4 goalkeeper from Mattoon, Illinois. Got to start in the last game against Hong Kong. Nearly held a clean sheet. Hong Kong through 84 minutes. Almost a bad giveaway there for the Blue Jays' true Iowa Wesleyan. Francisco Santana couldn't really do anything with it. It's about 6 minutes into this game now. Still 0-0.
Yeah, I'm liking the pace that both teams are playing with so far. I know I've said it before, but these two teams have kept it up. Both going back and forth very, very quickly. Not trying to surrender anything, but trying to make the most out of any little opportunity that can arise. Like right here almost is Garcia, and he turns it right back over.
Yeah, Garcia's trying hard not to get caught out of position. It was a center back trying to make a run up into the attacking third of the Blue Jays. They went right back, and they were just trying to catch him offside, or catch him out of position, I should say, dumping it over the top, but... good recovery there to get it right back. How about Wisniewski with a nice block there, trying to win it right back. It's going to fly out of bounds for a throw-in.
Wisniewski's been all over the pitch so far tonight. He had that first opportunity, almost being able to capitalize with the goal. He's had a lot of different runs. He's been a catalyst so far tonight for Westminster.
Maybe a free kick they call. Center referee Jamie Cody. Flanking him, Dan Carricker and Jonathan Mills on either side of the pitch as assistant referees. Ball being played over the top now. Good header away to thwart it was Aaron Gilliams. Here come the Blue Jays now with Colin Murray. Murray trying to find Wisniewski on the left side. Getting cleared away off the line by Sanchez coming off his line. Another Iowa Wesleyan player down, still on the field now. Haven't exactly caught a number for him yet. But another stoppage in play called. Is Raul Garcia, one of the two center backs, slow to get up as the trainers come out to meet him. Right at the 18-yard box as the clock stops right there as they change it back to 37-24. Garcia, senior center back from Madrid, Spain. And will be coming off the field, actually. Unclear if a substitute will meet him.
Hard to put some pressure on. It looks like his right knee is what he's holding.
Richard Neves is warming up to come in to replace him. another senior, actually, this time from Adelaide, Australia, subbing in to replace him at a left center back position. It's a throw in for the Blue Jays to be taken by Barrett Smith. He finds Wisniewski all the way down the corner, comes off of Wisniewski's chest and out of bounds. Another throw in coming up this time for Iowa Wesleyan. With it now, trying to build out of the back, goes to his left. To Stone. Stone trying to move the ball off the field again, intercepted by Westminster there. And again, switch the field, trying to have Chavez run onto it. This is Chase Vogt again, second time he's picked a ball up so far this game. Wisniewski trying to head it on. Uwe trying to run onto it. Good defense being played by the subbed on Richard Needs. To thwart it out again. This time it's going to be a throw in. And they love to play down in that left hand corner out of the sight lines. Long throw and coming up now for Westminster. Trying to be flipped on, gets flipped on to the front post, but Sanchez just lets it roll out of bounds into the side of the net. He'll distribute it quickly to Stone, though, to his left back. Jared Stone has a bit of space in front of him. In the midfield. So he's playing all the way out right now. With Rios. This is Christian Rios here linking to his left with Garcia. Stone. All the way. Up to Lozada. One back by the Blue Jays again, though, as a sit back on defense. There's Smith trying to play it over the top. Smith switching the field all the way. And Zarinelli trying to run onto it. He gets there first. Gerdeman trying to flick it off. It's still with the Blue Jays right now. Here's Gerdeman trying a overhead kick. How about Unyewe? Oh! Going over the bar. Stoppage of play called. They're going to say that Sanchez got a touch onto it. And a corner coming up for the Blue Jays right now. What a chance right there from Joshua Udinyewe.
And that was the best attempt that the Blue Jays have had so far tonight. They've had a few that Sanchez has had to make saves on, but that one was definitely the one that made him the most uncomfortable, just barely getting a finger on it as it went over his head. And that's the only reason that ball's not in the back of the net. What a great job of Udinyewe there, as Westminster had a few chances there to put it in the back of the net before it landed at his foot.
All the power, all the curve to make it beautiful, just inches too high. Another corner coming up. I believe just the fourth of the game for Westminster. Already about 11 minutes into this game. They played a few to the front post now. This was all the way to the back post. It's punched away by Sanchez. Come out to meet it, try to play a shot in. Here's a shot right now, and a goal. How about Jacob Scraggs being caught? Just staying onside, he says, as pretty much catching the entire Iowa Wesleyan team standing there. And they're all having a word with the assistant referee on the far side to wonder what happened. Jacob Scraggs, though, a senior from St. Louis, getting his first goal of the season. And actually, they will reverse their decision. Center referee. Excuse me, Jamie Cody having a word with the AR and calling him offside now. It's going to be a free kick as the goal still stands. As the score still stands, 0-0. Jonathan Mills is the assistant referee on the far side of the field, who is the one to make a decision. Never raised his flag. Jamie Cody was the one to correct him. We play on now. It's still 0-0.
Yeah, that all kind of happened so fast. It was almost like a blink and you miss it kind of play right there. Westminster thinks they have a goal. It looks like for a second they might, but not to be. And now the Westminster bench very happy when an offside is called on Iowa Wesleyan this time around.
Well, there weren't any cheers for any fans. There, it seems wasn't much of a reaction from the Westminster bench yet, but Jacob Scraggs was celebrating, as was the rest of the Westminster players on the field, and that was the only indication that there might have been a goal. He might have been onside. We play on, though, 0-0. Westminster still looking for their first goal here. Bouncing around the top of the box, eventually cleared away. All the way down that left-hand flank now. Nearly going out of bounds.
And Westminster isn't playing like a team that got shut out in its first game. They're playing as a team that has some purpose, as a team that wants to get, you know, the pace push and have the ball on the offensive end. Iowa Wesleyan has not really done much to try to break up this Westminster run, trying to get the ball on the other end. It's been all Blue Jays so far early on in this one, kind of the similar story to what we had in that first game.
Well, Westminster ceding possession, as it seems, to Iowa Wesleyan, letting them build out of the back, but getting that ball right back and trying to move quickly on offense when they do get the ball right back. But Wesleyan with the ball right now. Garcia on the far side with it now. Moving on to Stone. Good interception right there to get it back with Zarinelli. Couldn't really link play with Gurdyman right there, and Wesleyan gets it right back. Stone all the way up to Saldana. Saldana now trying to get it out wide to his teammate Lozada, but Blue Jays have it right back on a throw-in right at midfield. Gurdyman trying to run onto it, nearly getting it right back. Also fighting for it there is Colin Murray. Eventually won and just played all the way down the line, but out of bounds again by Iowa Wesleyan, giving the ball right back to the Westminster Blue Jays. Here they play with it now, so we're bouncing around. Neither team in possession with it now. Running onto it, trying to play it up high was Pacheco, but was there to clear it all the way away. Foul called there on midfield. Garcia's getting called for pushing Gurdyman down, and Westminster now with another free kick opportunity, a good set piece opportunity, about, call it, 40 yards out from goal.
Yeah, it's been a kind of a feeling them out process, I feel like, for Iowa Wesleyan so far. They're, you know, a team that obviously has gotten off to a great start this season, scored a lot of goals, but right now they're kind of just letting Westminster do whatever they want. They're kind of seeing what works, what doesn't, and they haven't allowed anything yet, so we'll see how long that Westminster can push this without getting something, because they've had the ball on the other end for what feels about 10, 15 minutes now, almost the entire game.
Ball was played to the back post. He knew it was there to try and get ahead on it. Just a little too high for him. It goes out of bounds for a goal kick for the Tigers. They'll play it quickly out to Garcia now. Westminster not with much of a press right now. Again, finding Pacheco. Good interception there again. Westminster, a bit of a low block, not trying to have the Tigers run on in behind the defensive line. There's Zarinelli out wide, trying to up high, play it up high. Here's Wisniewski running onto it. Excuse me, Wisniewski again, getting around Sachi's, laying it off for Uniwe, and a good defensive effort there to thwart it. You have to think, Wisniewski probably should have had a shot on goal there instead of laying it off.
I was going to say, Wisniewski had the open goal. Sanchez got out of the way. He tried to make a dive at it originally. Wisniewski was able to pull it back. If he had just taken one dribble and fired it at the net, it probably is a 1-0 lead. But instead, he tried to dump it off for, you know, maybe an easier shot at the time. But you got to know your situation and know that the goal is wide open for you if you want to take the shot.
Even if he closed his eyes and maybe just fired it towards the net, he probably could have found something, but instead decided to lay it off. It's about a throw in now for Iowa Wesleyan. Preseason polls had the Tigers finishing first in the SLIAC and had Westminster finishing fifth. So far, not much danger to the Westminster goal so far, as opposed to the Iowa Wesleyan one. Here comes Wisniewski running onto this one, touching the ball into the box, but Sanchez is there to collect it this time around.
Pretty much the same attack that happened last time around, but this time Sanchez able to get a little bit more of a jump on it, get there before Wisniewski's able to beat him. It made it look a lot easier than it did the first time around. The first time around, he got pretty lucky.
Rios with the ball now, connected with Pacheco. to Garcia. Out for Stone. Stone. With Romero getting a nice touch on it. Good defense gets it right back to the Blue Jays. All the way up for Gurdieman. Great defense being played. Great tackle by Garcia to knock it out of bounds. Timing it just perfectly on Gurdieman to knock it out from under him. Westminster still with the ball right now. So Smith. Smith giving it right up. Ball being played up high now. With Lozada trying to run onto it. Lozada being played into the box. And a goal again. It's Francisco Javier Saldana being called for a goal. No flag goes up on this one. This one will surely count. And now Iowa Wesleyan leads 1-0 here in just about, call it the 18th minute of play. The hands of Gian Andreas Francisco Santasola. Francisco Javier Saldana. I got it wrong. Saldana's being the one credited goalie, junior striker from Madrid, Spain. The yellow card being shown actually. To someone, they're standing right next to Javier Lozada's head center referee, Jamie Cody.
And I was just going to say, Will, before that attack, that since about the third or fourth minute of the game, that was the first time that, Iowa Wesleyan had the ball within 40 yards of the net, and they're just so quick in their attack. They make it happen so fast. That's why they can score so many goals in such a short amount of time. It's a blink of an eye kind of attack, and that's how they use it to get a 1-0 advantage.
Stone gives it up. Wisniewski trying to run onto it. Another good tackle there by Garcia to get it right back. Stone again with some space on the far side. We'll try to play it all the way up the middle. Foul being called on Lozado in the midfield. Javier Lozado. Having another chat with the referee. Free kick now for Westminster. Played off the back line, switching all the way to Uniwe on the far hand left side, gets headed out of bounds in favor of Westminster. Here's Schrader to take it right at midfield. Schrader down the line now. Still trying to go down the left-hand flank. Again, gets poked out of bounds for a Westminster throw-in. Again, Schrader taking a long one down all the way into the corner. He's having a long throw coming up from Barrett Smith. He's standing in the corner with nearly every single Westminster player standing inside the box, and he is attacking third. Trying to flick it on was Uniwe, gets poked out of bounds. Another corner coming up. I believe this is the fifth corner of the night already coming in this first half to Westminster, as they're down just 1-0. Iowa Wesleyan's only shot on goal. Play to the back post. A head was there. Get poked away now. Wesleyan trying to find them on the counterattack. Santasola right now gets ordered away and poked all the way down into the far right hand corner, into the parking lot. Actually, rolls the ball out of bounds for a throw in down for the Tigers. Down next to their own corner flag. So just about 21 minutes down in this one. With a little bit of a press now, trying to keep them in that corner. It rolls back two, past two Blue Jays, and now Iowa Wesleyan with a good 3-on-2 opportunity right now. It's with Saldana. He gets tripped up. And he yellow card being shown right now, certainly. JB Cody pulls it out for the second time this game.
That's an easy call for a yellow card. 3-on-2 opportunity. It was an easy chance for Iowa Wesleyan, and Sam Heckert just did what he had to do to prevent the goal from being scored. He'll take the yellow card if it means that, but it was a 3-on-2 break that looked like nothing but danger for Westminster. So you don't like to pick up that card necessarily so early in the match. You do so if it means you could save a goal.
Senior from Jefferson City, Missouri, Elias Catholic School down there. Hacker playing center back today and just coming out to try and thwart the counterattack. Free kick coming up now for Iowa Wesleyan, standing over it, Julio Olmedo. Olmedo will play it right to the center of the box. Boat comes out to catch it right into his chest. All thought about a quick distribution will let his fellow Blue Jays get further up the field before punting it very, very long, all the way deep for Gerdeman, bringing it down to his feet. Gerdeman trying to lay it off on Zarinelli on the overlap. Garcia gets there first, and again, kicks it way out of bounds for a throw-in coming up. Throw-in taking a little quickly, finds Gerdeman's chest, right at the top of the box, all the way down to Wisniewski now. Wisniewski trying to turn on it, has nowhere to go though, and it's again cleared away all the way deep. Westminster still with it here. On their back line, here's Heckert. Heckert trying to beat the plus, trying to find Zarinelli all the way down the right-hand flank. He's still fighting for it as the ball stays in bounds. Zarinelli's going to pick it up on Stone, and Stone's going to touch it out of bounds for Iowa Wesleyan. Westminster with a throw-in right now as it's in the hands of Luciano Zarinelli, a senior from St. Louis. And he'll drop it just for a moment for another long throw-in attempt. Westminster will crowd the box here. Right to the middle of the box, nearly cleared away again. Big collision right outside the box. A free kick coming up for Westminster, and another stoppage of play, and another yellow card is going to be shown, I believe.
You could hear the collision all the way from here, Will. Looks like Neves.
Richard Neves came in earlier.
That was a big, big collision. He was the injury substitute the first time, and now he comes in and is laying down the wood on.
Third, I mean, it was a 50-50 ball, but still, I believe these still got the better. I believe it was Murray out there. I could be wrong, though. But Westminster with a good free kick opportunity. Right at the edge of the box on the far side. Maybe too close of an angle to try for a shot on it, but.
And Westminster's had a plethora of chances so far here tonight. It was just the one chance that Iowa Wesleyan needed to score the goal. You got to wonder how many chances is it going to take Westminster? How soon can they get an equalizer? Can they get an equalizer before Iowa Wesleyan is able to strike lightning twice?
Take it in right to the middle of the box, bouncing around there. Shot, another goal this time. It's going to count for Westminster. 1-1 off the free kick. Didn't exactly catch who scored that one. But it was right there in the mixer, and as well as a Carolina Blue jersey was certainly the one to put it in. 1-0 now for the Blue Jays. Or excuse me, 1-1 as the Blue Jays tie it.
Absolutely huge equalizer there, Will. Needed that.
It was Jacob Skaggs who was the one who got his foot on it. I'll say. Skaggs actually the one to score the first one that got taken back because it was offside.
Able to make it right this time, get the equalizer, make it a 1-1 game. Huge opportunity there for the Blue Jays, and they take advantage of it.
And a plethora of substitutions coming in now for Westminster. I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Blue Jays coming onto the field now to replace the starting lineup.
You don't see something like that very often. Well, 7 substitutions at once. In a Serie A game, that's the entire substitution list.
Certainly unheard of as a Westminster seem to change their entire lineup besides their back line.
But, you know, you got to respect it because one thing it might do for you is you get some fresh legs out there and almost an entire new team of fresh legs. That, you could wonder if that might lead to something.
Well, there's certainly a feeling out process for a reason. Now this entirely new team of Blue Jays will have to almost go through that same process. As the game is tied now, 1-1, 22 minutes to go, about 23 minutes down now here in the first half. Skaggs picking up the goal, senior from St. Louis. Picking up the ball right now. Is the Blue Jays here? Schrader trying to keep it in bounds. He'll throw it for him. Inoue, the other Inoue, Phillip, who's the one who came into this game, is there to try and steal it away. Wesleyan nearly getting it right back. Westminster going with a little bit of a press right now as opposed to letting Iowa Wesley have time on the ball. Here's Diodone trying to play it out wide to Unyue, who collects it right in the corner. And it's going to be called for offside, actually. Substitution coming in, I believe, for Iowa Wesley, and they only make one. Let's judge him right out. Senior from Cardiff, Wales. Making way for him is David Chavez. Almost a straight swap. Now it looks like right out we'll play center mid and move Julio Olmedo out to the right wing position that Chavez was playing. This is Stone on the far side. Jared Stone with a very nice turn. Has a bit of space down the right hand, left hand flank, but doesn't really have a teammate to find it. Wesleyan gets it right back though. Ball played underneath us is Richard Neves. Foul from behind him. It's Francois Mbua getting called for the foul. And Cody wants to have a talk with Muda again. No card shown yet for Mua, but three already from the center referee, Jamie Cody, already. Just about 25 minutes in this game. Very chippy so far. Here's Olmedo to play it in. Plays it right to the center of the box, headed away. Diodone picks it up now for the Blue Jays. He'll play Unyewe, trying to find down the left-hand wing. The ball's played all the way back into Boat's box, where he'll collect it very easily. Kick all the way deep, looking for Lieberman to pick it up. Inoue finds it. Connecting now, here's Diodone right underneath us. Connecting with Gilliams, Diodone again trying to use his strength there. Going out of bounds now for an Iowa Wesleyan throw-in. Coming up just a little bit short. He'll wait for a second, though. Actually take this throw in. Favoring his right calf. Just barely keeping it inbounds underneath us. Unyue gets it right back, though, for the Blue Jays. Trying to use his pace. Can't exactly have a lot of space, though. Goes out of bounds for Iowa Wesleyan throw. Whistle being called as a fight almost. As he changes the decision again, he's able to take the throw in, but again, JB Cody just holding him up for a second. Telling him to retake the throw in. bounces out of bounds. This time, it will be in favor of Iowa Wesleyan. They will take it this time.
We had a very, very eccentric and quick pace for the first half of this first half, but it's kind of slowed down almost to a halt now after that Westminster goal to even things up. I think both teams kind of are settling in now, realizing the 1-1 draw is where they might be for quite some time before someone gets something else.
Well, I think the referees kind of noticed how chippy it was getting. It was trying to slow down the pace intentionally to clean the game up a little bit. What it was kind of come to is this is almost a stop, a halt in the pace and tempo of it. Who's getting trying to play it down the line now. Giordano fighting Mua in the midfield. Francois Mua. Side now with Schrader. Westminster trying to link play now. It's going to be played all the way out of bounds for your Blue Jays throw in. Schrader will take it. He's going to be switched from left back to right back after Diodone came in to fill the left back role. Handball called right around midfield on the far side in favor of Westminster. They'll have a long free kick opportunity with Mua standing over it right now. 16 and a half still to go. In this first half, both teams looking to break the tie once again. Mua plays a very long ball all the way to the back post. There to get a foot on it was Freddie Manet, but it came off the bar. And a foul and another yellow card shown. A fourth one of the game, this time to Philip Udinyewe for colliding with the goalkeeper Sanchez.
Yeah, that's a risk I don't know if I would take if I was Udinyewe there. The ball was, you know, high up in the air, right by the goalkeeper there. You know he's going to – it's in his area. He's going to go up and try to get it if he's going to have the chance. A risky play to make right there, and you pick up a yellow card for something that might not have gone your way, even if everything went according to plan.
Three yellow cards now for Westminster, one for Iowa Wesleyan here in the first half here. As Gilliam's picking up the ball now for Westminster, trapping himself in a corner, just right off of the window. Another free kick opportunity coming from Iowa Wesleyan. Olmedo standing over it alongside Rideout. Rideout will let Olmedo have it. Played it all the way to the center of the box, headed away by Mua. Rideout gets his foot on it, but just shanks it a little bit, comes out rolling all the way here outside the box. Diodone is going to let it ride all the way out of bounds, getting the space for him and leave it ride for Gilliams to throw it.
Yeah, Rideout read that perfectly. He was in the right place at the right time, but just shanked it off the top of his foot, it seemed like. Didn't really get anything on there at all, and instead of it being a 2-1 game, we're still all evened up.
Stoppage of play as JB Cody's going to back up Udinyewe just a tiny bit again. In the hands of Gilliams. Down the left-hand flank now. In favor of Iowa Wesleyan, all the way down in that corner. And we're coming up for Sanchez. One one being played. Eckert was one who got his head on it first. Here's Olmedo now. Sanchez now, 60 yards from his goal, playing it all the way out on the left side, connecting with a Blue Jay though, but maybe it was Matthew Schulte who got his foot on it for Westminster. Couldn't exactly catch Sanchez off his line. 13 minutes left to play as the substitution is being made by Iowa Wesleyan. Julio Olmedo coming off the field. Making Efren Alvardo. Excuse me, no, that's Thomas Caruda. We're number 18. Central midfielder from Canada. Ball being played all the way to Philip Unyue. Here he is at midfield trying to fight for it. Bua picks it up for Westminster. Dona out wide now. Gilliam's trying to catch someone over the top. Finds a purple head though.
Westminster trying to utilize the long ball a lot more as this half tries to wear on, trying to catch Iowa Wesleyan sleeping as they're starting to toughen up on the defensive side. Not a lot of the opportunities that Westminster had at the beginning of the half are there anymore.
Free kick being called in favor for Iowa Wesleyan. Standing there at the American Football 30-yard line. Right out, standing over it. Hit play into the box, headed away by Heckers. Picking up is Schulte. Schulte with the man on his back just has to clear it all the way down into the corner. This is Neems now for Iowa Wesleyan. Inside with Pacheco. On the far side now as the wing picks up the Soldano. Poked out of bounds by Schulte. In the hands of Stone with Rideout. Rideout trying to play it up towards the top of the back line. Cleared away. A foul being called this time against Iowa Wesleyan. This may actually be an offside. Called against Javier Lozano. A Blue Jay player. This is Neves all the way in the corner for Iowa Wesleyan, trying to clear it away. And Yiwe is there to play defense. It's being played all the way up the left, right hand flank, excuse me. Here comes Sandra Sola connecting inside. Right out has it outside. Good defense being played right there, thwarted away by Schrader out of bounds. So a big reaction from his bench. With a throwing. Trying to catch them off quickly. It's Lieberman on the far side. Ari Lieberman taking it inside the box. Poked away, out of bounds. Beat by Central Solo. Long throwing now, coming up for Westminster. Played all the way across the box, no one home for Westminster to run onto. Didona was there trying to keep it in. That was out for another Iowa Wesleyan throw-in. Sanchez has it all the way outside of his goal, trying to find Soldano down the left-hand flank. This is right out. Zada. Pacheco playing it over the top. Nobody home there, I think. His teammate Saldana might have been offsides, cleared all the way up the field. Iowa Wesleyan trying to just keep this ball pretty much on the Westminster side on the field in the past few minutes or so. This is Saldana crossing all the way to Corona. Thomas Corrado will take a shot now and easily corralled into the hands of Vogt.
It's kind of been a role reversal here in this last 15 minutes or so. It's been a lot of Iowa Wesleyan pushing against Westminster now, trying to get their second goal, trying to take the lead once again. They've done a good job of now taking the ball and keeping it in Westminster's zone. Giving them a little bit of a taste of their own medicine from what they got in the first 25 or so minutes.
Westminster have a free kick now in a very similar spot from where they scored earlier in this half, being played right to the top of the box, headed away now. Right now is able to pick it up and play it all the way deep, looking for Javier Lozano to try and run onto. Hecker gets there first and headed away. There's Mua trying to pick it up for Westminster. Saldana gets it actually for Iowa Wesleyan, dancing around with it. Going out left now to Pacheco. Saldana, now Javier Lozano trying to get a shot off, rolling into the arms of Chase Vogt again. Sola. Touching it out of bounds last. Throwing now for Westminster. Do you do it? I try to pick it up. Westminster gets it right back. Out of bounds after the throw in. Gilliam's going quickly. Neves in the midfield, all the way out left for Stone. One back though by Westminster. It's all the way with Matthew Schulte. Try and go up high. Uyewe is there and try to run onto it. Picked up by Iowa Wesleyan again. Uyewe getting called for a foul on behind. Christian Rios is back in the game. Stoppage in play. Rios is down for the second time this game. He's out, though, and center referee Jamie Cody is having a word with Philip Uyewe.
Been a very physical game so far.
Sanchez playing a long ball deep. Handball being called right in the center. The handball. Another free kick opportunity now for Iowa Wesleyan. Trying to run out standing over it. About, call it 42 yards out from goal. Right out. The back post still bouncing around there. Offside being called against Iowa Wesleyan though on any of the five players who were in the box. Maybe Saldana was there. He was the one who tried to get his head on it.
Saldana's started to come alive. He had that one goal, of course, the goal that was the first of the game, and ever since then he's been doing whatever he can to try to get people open and make the right play. He's a very crafty dribbler. He's able to get around a lot of defenders rather easily as well, so he's someone to watch out for.
Trying to have a word with Diodone and as well as Gian Andres Franceschi Santosola. Mainly to Diodone though. Long throw it now coming in for Westminster. They can act like it's a set piece. whistle to resume. And we do. Long throw to the front post, trying to be flipped on. He gets headed away. Nay's there to try and put it back in. Uniwe there. Get tackled again out of bounds. With another Westminster long throw in coming. Thrown all the way out of bounds, though, out of bounds for a goal kick. Sanchez playing quickly out left to Stone. This is Garcia. Nearly intercepted, though, is going to be picked up by Westminster on their back line. Here's Heckert. Now Wilder out for Schulte. Down the line for Lieberman. Ari Lieberman with a good tackle by Garcia to thwart it. Westminster with another throw in again. Mua in the midfield. Diadone. Nowhere to go. Wesley gets it right back. Giving it right back to the Blue Jays. So now the team seems to be able to string a couple passes together and keep control of it for more than 10 seconds. It's Franceschi Santosola. Lozada. Lozada trying to switch the field to Saldana. Saldana out in the far corner, dancing around with it, taking it inside the box now. Lays it off for Santosola. Nowhere to go. Heckers wanted to get his foot on it. And clear it away. Lieberman's fighting for Westminster. One back though for Iowa Wesleyan. He's right out in the midfield. Right out making his way around three Blue Jays. Crossing it, nearly looking for Lozada. So only just about 2 minutes away from the halftime. Still 1-1 here, but this has really been a tale of two halves just here in this first half.
Well, most definitely. Well, the first half of this first half was, you know, lights out. Both teams pushing the pace, going back and forth. A goal for each side. But ever since Westminster was able to equal us up and even at one apiece, things have really slowed down and it's been sloppy from both sides and it's been a lot of back and forth, not a lot of action though.
He's right out in the midfield for Iowa Wesleyan, trying to play it over the top of for Saldana again, poked away, decides out of bounds. No, just barely kept in bounds by Schulte. Tiger will try and clear it though. Comes off a Tiger player, last out of bounds. Westminster will have it thrown on the far side. About 45 seconds to do anything. Take the lead maybe here in this first half. Nene trying to play down the right hand flank. Called for a foul though against Iowa Wesleyan as he's clipped up. Good freaking opportunity here as Westminster will have to go a little quicker. 20 seconds still left. Gilliams plays it to the top of the box. Flipped on by Lieberman. Diodone is trying to run onto it. Gets cleared away, though. Out of bounds. Still 10 seconds left on the clock. Kept in. No, they're going to call a throw-in. And with just 5 seconds left, that should surely end the first half of play here at Blue Jay Stadium. Keith and Judith Mueller's Field. 1-1 between Westminster and Iowa Wesleyan here in the SLEAC. As we head into the second half of action, so 45 minutes to play. This game could certainly still go either way as both teams have been trying to knock on the door for their second goal of the game. We're going to take a break here for the next 15 minutes or so, and we can come back the second half of action here from Folsom, Missouri. second half of action here at Blue Jay Stadium. Keith and Judith Mueller Field, Westminster versus Iowa Wesleyan, Sleek Men's Soccer. Will Nolte here alongside Connor McCann.
We were talking about it during the break, and when Westminster made that huge group substitution after scoring that goal, seven players subbing on right after the goal was scored, it did a lot to take away the momentum from the guys that were on the field, the guys that had figured out how to poke a hole in this Iowa Wesleyan defense. So it's very interesting to see what they want to do this time around and how they want to manage it.
Try to pick it up right now. Playing it over. That was Barrett Smith now on the far side for UA. That's Joshua, to be exact. One back though by Iowa Wesleyan. They have a couple numbers forward. They're going to play it up. Saldana's trying to run onto it. He will nearly get there. Hecker's going to pick it up though for Westminster and distribute it out. Still bouncing around the far side for any team to pick up. Iowa Wesleyan has it right now. Foul called around the 40-yard line against Westminster. Referee Jamie Cody tried to play advantage as far as he can, but nothing really came of it for Iowa Wesleyan, and it will give the foul. Free kick coming up. Julio Olmedo standing over it. After some hesitation, Olmedo's free kick into the box. Saldano's there. Maybe that was Sucker Solo, who was also there, just a little too far over his head. Out of bounds for a goal kick now for Westminster.
Yeah, Santasola had a chance to put a head on it, and there was nobody within 3 or 4 yards of him. They kind of forgot about him. Missed opportunity there for the Tigers.
Chase Smoke Seal between the sticks for Westminster. About to midfield. Gertie Bay got his head on it. Here's now for Westminster. Here's Newski. Foul from behind on him. They'll play it quickly though. Here comes Gertie trying to break down the right hand flank. Taking it to the corner. He'll land off now right behind him. The goal scorer Skaggs will play one in. Skaggs now trying to pick it back up. He'll get there first. Long ball being played. Switch all the way to Umiewe. That's right there is Sanchez to beat it. And distribute it very quickly. Throwing on the far side now. Coming for Iowa Wesleyan. As we're only about 4 minutes into this first half, but it seems the tempo has picked up certainly a lot more than how we finished the first half.
Substantially, Will. At the end of that first half, the last 15 minutes or so, kind of felt like nothing was happening. Not a whole lot was going, just two teams passing back and forth to each other in the midfield. But this time already, both teams with some early chances here in the second half.
Here's Gurdyman now trying to send it across a little too far over the bar. Skaggs was there to try to get a head on it on the back post, but just ended up out of bounds instead. Goal kick coming up for Iowa Wesleyan. Playing short now. Thomas Caruto. Stone. So trying to play it down the left hand flank. It's a throw in for himself. And he'll come back and take it. All the way back at Sanchez's feet is Caruto now. See me play center back. Sanchez now trying not to get caught outside of his own box. Wisniewski was there to try to intercept it.
Caruto with a poor pass right there made life very, very difficult for Sanchez. Almost gave up a freebie goal.
And giving one up right again. Caruto sending it right to Unyewe here. Joshua Unyewe trying to send a low cross in. Poked away out of bounds by Christian Garcia. Another corner kick coming up for Westminster now. It's about only 6 minutes into this second half. 51st minute of play.
Two poor giveaways for Caruto right there. The first almost turns into a freebie goal, and the second leads to a corner kick. We'll see if Westminster, who is starting the second half like they started the first, with the pace and attacking on their mind. See if they can get something to go off of another set piece like they did in the first.
In swinging free kick to be played in. Excuse me, corner kick is right to the near post. It's got a head on it by Iowa Wesleyan all the way out. Outside there is going to be a goal kick coming off the foot of Aaron Gillians, I believe. Sam Sanchez go and collect. Here's Thomas Garuda now seemingly playing center back after coming in as a sub in the first half to play center defensive mid or center midfield position. Trying to play it over the top right now. It was Lozada trying to run onto it down in the corner. Still in play now, trying to be distributed. It's going to be a throw-in in favor of Westminster, I believe. I think it might be a foul called right there after the trip up. Iowa Wesleyan will have a free kick and a good opportunity in good position here. Swing one into the box. Still waiting for the West referee's whistle. Here it comes now on the free kick for Iowa Wesleyan. As he backs up the wall just a tiny bit. The referee does. Whistle blown. Free kick being taken now. All the way to the top of the box. Tiger player hit the deck. Trying to get a shot off on. It was Pacheco being cleared off the line though. Out of bounds though for Iowa Wesleyan. Threw it on the far side. Carlos Taylor to take it in his hands. Ends up at Chavez's feet. They'll reset though all the way back. There's Olmedo trying to do something with it. Ruta running onto it to get his head on it. Westminster nearly wins it right back though. Olmedo has it, picks it up for Iowa Wesleyan. They'll try and play it down the left hand flank. Westminster now coming up with it. Here's Gerdyman getting tripped up from behind. They'll call a foul on Curry right behind it. Westminster with a free kick. Nearly breaks underneath us. Jamie Cody is having a word with Thomas Caruto.
Yeah, I think Caruto was a little upset because when he headed the ball a moment ago, he thought he was fouled coming down. And then he thought he did not get much of Skaggs on the foul called on him on the other end. So I think the referee just telling him just to watch out, make sure you're playing a clean game, as he has not been shy of throwing out cards so far in this one.
Westminster bench there, just standing up all along down that touchline.
It almost looks like a student section, Will, with all the players they have over there.
Lining up right, only where they can. None sitting down. Might be too cold for them to sit down, trying to stay warm. Westminster will have another throw in here in the hands of Aaron Gilliams. Left back. Way up to Gerdyman, top of the box. Yewe is also there. Nearly cleared away. All the way was to Carhoff. So Donna picks it up now for Iowa Wesleyan. Try to go quickly. He gets fouled right at midfield by Hecker. He needs to be careful because he's already on a yellow card from the first half. No card showed this time around. And only a free kick now for Iowa Wesleyan.
That's one of the problems with picking up the first yellow card so early. You might want to play a challenge that...
Out from goal. Here's Christian Garcia now to play the ball in. All the way to the center of the box. Comes into the hands of Chase Bowe, who is fouled underneath him. Free kick being played now.
I guess with the strength of that kick, I guess those few extra yards might have made a difference after all.
Minutes in to this second half. Ball plays in midfield, picked up by Wisniewski. Wisniewski trying to use his pace, gets it into the box now, take it all the way to the touchline, plays a low cross across the box, it's cleared away. Skaggs trying to clean it up, picked up though by Pacheco, giving it away right back to Westminster, and out of bounds, sends it. Aaron Smith. Stone on the throw in now for Iowa Wesleyan. Long one all the way to Lozada, gets played out of bounds. Another Tigers throw in coming up. Stone with flat ball all the way out to Pacheco. Crossing it. Far side, David Chavez picks it up, sends it out for Rios. Rios playing back in, looking for Chavez, cleared off the line again, this time by Eckers, by Westminster. Picked up by Gerdyman. Gerdyman trying to play Wisniewski in behind, didn't exactly find him, got deflection. Ball with Lozada now for Iowa Wesleyan, trying to touch it up to Soldano. Lozada again. Skaggs will now collect it right back for Westminster. Playing it down the line was fouled from behind by Saldana. Barrett Smith standing over it. Played short, nearly intercepted, picked up by Wisniewski. Reset behind him.
Center Sola comes up with that interception. He's got a wide open Saldana able to cut down the field.
Here comes Gerdyman. No foul call from behind. I say he tripped up on his own just a little bit. And a foul in response by Jordan Koroff. Multiple fouls, another one that's been being pulled down. Colin Murray is going to get booked for this one. The fourth yellow card against Westminster.
I mean, that was an easy one. He grabbed on the shirt, threw him down to the ground. I mean, that was textbook right there. A very frantic couple seconds right there with all the fouls being called and one not being called, of course, for Westminster in the corner there. And, you know, the way that fouls have been called all night, kind of surprised to see that first one not get called. And then the small contact on the first foul by Westminster being called almost immediately right after, followed by the yellow card, of course. So not surprised with the yellow card. It clearly warranted one, but a little surprised that first one in the corner was not called the foul, just considering the way things have been called all night long.
Yeah, I think the center referee, Jimmy Cody, just thought Gerdyman was trying to draw a foul too hard, or was really going into it too much, going down too easy, really. Westminster certainly got mad about that. Karhoff on his foul, and certainly afterwards on Murray.
And you do see that a lot in the corner, especially just because of the favorable position you can get from getting a free kick in that area.
Zoom now. Here's Gerdyman trying to pick it up now. No foul called on this one either. Westminster getting right back though. Uyewe taking it down the left-hand flank. Good tackle there. To thwart it was Rios. Nice sliding tackle out of bounds.
Great tackle by Rios right there in a very tough spot to do it, especially in the box. Don't want to give up the penalty kick, of course, but a very smart and very calculated tackle right there to force the ball to go out of bounds, but Westminster still threatening.
Long throw coming up right now. I believe it's in the hands of Barrett Smith on the far side. Five Blue Jays crowd the box. All the way to the center of the box, if it's headed away nearly. Picked up by Gertyman, all the way out to Smith again. Gets poked out of bounds by Iowa Wesleyan. Long throw finds Wisniewski there. Gets picked up again by Iowa Wesleyan. A long pass all the way finds Javier Lozada at midfield. Lozada with a little bit of space. He'll cross it all the way to Saldana, trying to run into the box in it. Hope gets there first for Westminster. We'll try and play out of the back. Smith's pass couldn't find any similar light blue shirts. Iowa Wesleyan now with a chance to reset. Here's Almeida. Up left of Stone. Up for Lozada. Trying to run onto it. Going out of bounds for a throw in again for Iowa Wesleyan. It up in the midfield, nearly gives it up, picks up Pacheca again, sends it out wide, now to Rios. Rios to Almeida, trying to play it over the top, Saldana's there to run onto it, here comes Saldana, Vogt gets there and collides with him, and catches it into his hands.
Vogt and Saldana look like they exchanged some words too after that one. But Vogt has every right to reclaim that as his keeper.
Wisniewski taking it inside the box. Wisniewski, nice tackle there again. This time coming from Christian Garcia to knock it out of bounds. Off of him, though, the corner for Westminster coming up. As Wisniewski just trying to beat him down the touchline.
Wisniewski, from the moment this game started, has been the Westminster player that has done the best at running down the field both ways and trying to get his guys open and trying to create some space for himself as well. He's been a very, very great player tonight for Westminster, possibly the man of the match.
Six Blue Jays players in the box right now. Played to the front post, headed away by Stone for Iowa Wesleyan. Still dangerous, though. Opportunity. As Stone gets the interception now. It was a little too far from him as Hecker tries to pick it right back up again and gets called for a foul. Here for Almeida. Left for Stone and referee Jamie Cody will back it up again. Sanchez plays it very long. Saldana's there. Heckercraft there first with his head. Trying to pick it up again. Long ball being played from Garcia. Saldana was offside. We'll let it ride all the way to the goalkeeper, Chase Vogt. 25 minutes still to play, though. This is Wisniewski with it on the far side. Gilliams will play it over the top. Trying to collect it was Gertyman. Justin Gertyman just couldn't get the right foot on it. Rolls out of bounds for a throw-in.
Just out of the reach of Gertyman. Gertyman's hitting, he's been a lot more involved in this second half than he was in the first.
There's Gertyman now. Nice pass. Unyewe inside the box. Trying to cut it back. Good save there. Poking away with Sanchez. On the rebound now, Barrett Smith with a nice shot. Rolling into the arms of Sanchez again, who'll distribute it quickly. Good opportunity for Westminster there. Here comes, though, Iowa Wesleyan. This was Santosola.
Absolute rocket there from Smith, but just couldn't find the hole behind Sanchez.
Nice tackle by Gilliams on the far side to thwart the counterattack, sending it out of bounds. Stoppage of the clock as Wisniewski was a little slow to get up, I believe. He'll actually be subbed off. Coming onto the field is Philip Unyewe. Playing striker, his brother Joshua. And he was playing about left mid. Still a throw-in coming up for Westminster. Iowa Wesleyan on the far side. As the referee wants to fix the clock. Put 12 more seconds back on it. Long kick coming now finds ahead of Almeida. Hecker will play it right back. Ye was there. Wild attempt there. Gets poked out of bounds. Off the foot of Kendall Schrader. Throw coming for Iowa Wesleyan now. Try and dance around with it. And again goes out of bounds for a Westminster throw in. Playing down the flank, still a scramble for it in that midfield. Westminster clearly trying to pick it up. Saldana comes up with it, trying to play it in behind. Here comes Santosola. Too heavy of a touch there. Cheka got his foot on it, but a long, wild shot gets flown out of bounds. Three substitutions now coming on for Westminster.
And I'm a little worried, Will, and we're getting more of the same of what we saw in the first half. The first 25 minutes, very, very exciting, full of action, but the last few we've kind of slowed down a little bit and have kind of gone back to that back and forth in the midfield. I have to wonder if it might just be fatigue. It is a cold night here as well.
I see Matthew Schulte coming onto the field alongside Freddie Nene. Joe Wilder, yes, comes on. Those three substitutions coming onto the field. Iowa Wesleyan trying to play it over the top. Here's Schrader now for Westminster with his back to goal. Has a man behind him. He's going to leave it off for Chase Boat. Never touched it with his foot, so it's not going to be a back pass. And Chase was easily able to pick it up. And punts it all the way down the field. Here comes Schulte getting his head on it. Still a fight for it. Saldana's going to pick it up, though, for Iowa Wesleyan. Play it out to Pacheca. Pacheca all the way up to Javier, who lays it off. Santosola, who got a shot on it. And just throws over the bar again for a goal kick. Nice linkage play for Iowa Wesleyan to set up a good opportunity there.
That's probably the best play they've had since they scored that first goal. Santosola, it was a very tough shot for him to hit. It was a good pass, but for him to have put that in the back of the net, he would have had to lob it up and volley it, you know, with his left foot in the middle of the air. He would have had to get up pretty high. It would have been a very, very tough one, but very, very good play from Iowa Wesleyan. That was the best set piece they've had so far. They set up Sarasota, Santorisola very, very well. He's unable to finish, but a good, good pass from Rios.
John Andres Franceschi Santorisola had two goals last week against Fontbon. Yet to find the net tonight. We're so close there. Still 1-1 here. We're just about 20 minutes still to play. Here's Freddie Nene trying to break the tie. Putting Yeway down the left-hand flank. Has his brother in there. Joshua trying to get there. Excuse me, that was Philip off of Joshua's cross. Press coming. Unyewe gets it right back and plays it to his brother. Here's the other one. Joshua Unyewe trying to play across it. He gets poked out of bounds. Quarter coming up now for Westminster.
It was great work from Unyewe. Both of the twins right there putting in some good work to win the ball back and try to put their teammates in some good positions. Almost that crucial go-ahead goal for Westminster right there on the cross from Udinewe to his brother, but just couldn't connect on it. They do have a corner, though. Hopefully they can get something off this. Another set piece. They've had quite their fair share of corners tonight.
Six Blue Jays in the box. Played to the front post, headed away. No Blue Jay was really near it. second chance opportunity is going to come on the in-swinger. Udin Yewe is there just over his head. Saldana's going to pick it up, though, for Iowa Wesleyan. And roll out of bounds. Throwing coming up now for Westminster, taken quickly by Farhol. Udin Yewe trying to head it on behind him, trying to flick him onto anybody. Poor clear, so ends up at nearly Nene's feet, but a nice little back spinning ball ends up with a...
You have to wonder if he planned that backspin right there, because it was just so perfect, went right into his teammate's lap almost.
Throw it on the far side there for Westminster. He might make it a long one, yes. In the hands of Philip Udin Yewe. Set piece. All the way to the middle of the box. Nearly headed into the goal. Nearly was an own goal. Came off the left-hand post. Out of bounds. Going to be a corner kick coming up off of, I believe that was Jared Stone's head.
Stone got very, very lucky right there. Almost looked like he was an offensive player on that set piece the way that header made its way towards the goal. But he knows what he's doing. He figured he could get enough of it to force out of bounds but not get it into the back of the net. And it'll be yet another corner for Westminster.
Francois Yvrua standing over it. Take what should be an in-swinging corner. All the way, this was to the back post. Sanchez got his hand on it. Nene on the rebound. Counterattack, nearly counterattack opportunity for Iowa Wesleyan. Played all the way down near the corner. Throw it for Iowa Wesleyan in their own territory. Yeway flies out of bounds, trying to chase after it. Westminster with a bit of a press. And they lay off for just a moment. Here's Stone now. Stone, nearly stopped by Schulte, but just out of bounds. Schulte with a nice tackle in right behind his feet. Sardana coming back for it, gives it up. Here's Schulte now trying to play inside for Udin Yewe. Not there. Rua will pick it up in the midfield. Right at midfield. Play it behind him. Hecker now trying to play down the left-hand wing. Picked up again now. This is, David Chavez. Nene gets it right back. Here he is, Freddie Nene. Right side, Matthew Schulte. Gerdyman running on to it. Gerdyman! Not get called for a foul. Ruka was there on the tackle with a nice one. That's going to go out of bounds for a Westminster throw-in.
Looks like they're going to try to make it another long one.
A long throw coming up to 16 minutes still to play in this game. Score still stands 1-1. We'll have a bit of extra time with two 10-minute periods. Golden goal rules. Long throw to the front post. Unyewa was there to get his head on it. Poked away and cleared away. Westminster will get it right back, though. Here's Unyewa now, fighting Matthew Schulte on the shot. Right into the arms of Sanchez. He'll try and distribute it quickly. Saldana picks it up. Fight in between him and Wilder. Foul called against Saldana. Free kick now for Westminster coming up. Just about 32 yards outside the goal. Long word from the referee, Jamie Cody. Rua is standing over it. Gerdyman comes back to it. Matthew Schulte is also there to possibly take this. Four other Blue Jays in the area. Three of them in the box. Looks like it will be Gerdyman. Justin Gerdyman, the lone man standing over it. Senior from Candleton, Missouri. He'll play it short. Schulte trying to run onto it. Gets poked away by Garcia. Garcia with a nice play down his own left-hand flank. try and play with Sassuolo. Nearly give it away though. Here's Stone playing advantage. All the way up top for Lozada. Lozada in behind him is Chavez. Back for Rios. Rios playing it over the top. Lozada trying to run onto it. Headed away though by Westminster. They'll have it back now. On the back line, fighting for it is Garcia. Nice little turn right there at midfield for a center back. Still trying to pick it up. Has no real teammates, but have to go behind them to Rios. Under 14 minutes still to play. So with the 76th minute of action, here's Garcia again. Nearly took a nice bounce. Saldano's there to chase after it. Vogt has to come all the way out to the very top of his box to collect it.
Both teams showing the desperation now. They don't want to go into an extra period. They want to get it done in this final 13 and a half minutes.
Throw in, though, for Westminster right around midfield. Here's Wilder in the midfield. Left-hand flank. This is Wisniewski making his way through three. Nearly three before being cleared away. After the clearance, it's going to be a Iowa Wesleyan throw-in.
You can tell Wisniewski picked up right where he left off. The second he gets back into the game, they give him the ball immediately and let him go to work.
Pacheco in the midfield. He'll play it over the top. Looking for Lozada, who got a head on it. Wilder will pick it up in the midfield. Lay it off for Heckert behind him. Gilliam's got his head on it too. Goes out of bounds. Westminster will have a throw-in on the far side. All the way down to Wisniewski. The left-hand flank. Nice little touch. Being able to pick it up. On the left-hand flank. Playing in. Nene's there. Picked up by Sanchez, who plays it quickly. All the way to Javier Lozada, trying to run onto it. Heckert gets there first. This is Matthew Schulte now. He takes just a poor touch from him. Out of bounds now. Giving it right back to Iowa Wesleyan.
Unforced error right there. No one even near Schulte, and he just let's it go heavy off his foot and out of bounds.
Far side now for Rios for Iowa Wesleyan. Stolen away by Udinyewe. Fight for it. Here he is. Poked out of bounds via Westminster throw in. All the way down the left hand flank. Wisniewski running onto it. Garcia gets there first and pokes it out of bounds. It's going to be a throw in very near the corner flag. How long Westminster have been throwing the ball in, you can maybe suspect it could be almost equal to a quarter.
They've done a great job at that long throw in into the box. They've had, you know, multiple opportunities to practice it so far tonight. This will be about the fourth or fifth long throw in they've gone for. Nothing successful yet, but it's been there almost every time.
Here it is again. Clear to the top of the box. No foul called as Iowa Wesleyan now has a chance for a counterattack. Westminster definitely fired up and get it right back. Udinyewe on the left-hand flank now. We'll switch the play all the way to Schulte. Stone got there first to clear it away. This is Gilliams picking up the center back, Gilliams. Schulte now playing Gilliams down the right-hand flank now. Gilliams play across into the box, right into the hands of Vicente Sanchez. A stoppage and play called by the referee. Is a Iowa Wesleyan player down at midfield. I believe that is Rios, Christian Rios.
It was right after that contact that was not called. It was in the middle of that chaos. There were two that probably could have been called as fouls, but neither one of them were. And on the second one, Rios just got absolutely leveled.
Rios still on the ground now. A sophomore from Bolivia. Transfer from Johnson Community College. Whenever he does get up, it looks like it to be now will be a drop ball for Iowa Wesleyan.
Hey,
believe it is Richard Neves coming back into the game to replace him, yes. Drop ball as we resume here. Stone. Stone double team. Foul called against Schulte. Trying to do the referee's job for him.
That was Wisniewski right there. He's fired up.
Ball backed up. For Sanchez to get a long free kick. He'll play it all the way down the left-hand flank to the top of the box. Stone is there to try and run onto it. For a goal kick again, this time to Westminster. Just under 9 minutes to play here. Aiden Fulton. Goal kick taken right to midfield. Flicked on. Wisniewski trying to run onto it. Picked up by Freddie Nene. Left side, Schulte's there. Matthew Schulte with the now, touching around Stone. Here's Uniyewe trying to have a kind touch to him. Picked up by Sanchez, though. This is Saldana. Saldana trying to play it to his right, gets clear again. Here in the midfield now, foul called against Freddie Nene. Opportunity now for Iowa Wesleyan, just about a long ways away from goal. Julio Olmedo standing over it. Olmedo's cross into the center of the box, but brings it right into his hands. He'll wait a second for his teammates to get up the field. Good goalkeeping presence as all night Chase Moat has been. Another stoppage in play as Wisniewski slow to get up after the collision. Referee just doing a little concussion protocol as, you know, Wisniewski and, you know, Scorbuto collided heads.
You can hear the clap of the heads from up here, so, you know, the referee just wanted to make sure that Wisniewski is okay, and I'm sure Wisniewski does not want to have to go to the sidelines right now with just 7 minutes left in a tie game in regulation, but you got to make sure he's okay, so I understand completely.
No one yet to come in to replace him. It's going to be, I believe that's Gertyman. Justin Gertyman coming in back to the game. Patrick Wisniewski coming off just to be checked by the trainers for concussion protocol. He looked to be fine. He looked to kind of be against the substitution. But just sort of protocol when two players collide heads like that, you just don't want to take any risk when it comes to brain injuries. Here's Olmedo in the midfield. Saldana running in behind. Chase Moat again coming out to collect that ball.
Boat's been doing that all night long. He's been doing a good job of it. These Wesleyan strikers just don't even have a chance to get the ball into the box without just getting out there and making sure he's got a hand on it.
There's Gertyman on the far side. Throw in now for Iowa Wesleyan. Richard Neves. Go, 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 go. ball bouncing though, right out of bounds though. Throw it taken quickly. Here's Udinyewe being tracked down the left hand flank. Nice little nutmeg. Udinyewe to the top of the box. Rua trying to run out of his way. Rua's shot just to the wide of the bar.
I'm not sure why he took the extra dribble there. I thought he had the shot on Conte. All he had to do was run up to the ball and kick it. He might have had his first goal of the day and the winner in the 85th minute, but instead he takes the extra dribble and hits it wide.
Maybe just a thing of balance. Maybe he felt he was off balance, just needed that one extra touch to get it right onto his sweet spot, but maybe just too heavy of a touch. Westminster now, Wisniewski is back in the game right here. They're taking off Gerdyman. Out of bounds though. Iowa Wesleyan will have a throw in just out of sight. Freddie Dene nearly getting it back. Shielding it out of bounds for a throw in. All the way into the box is Udinyewe. Touching it over the defender. Sanchez coming out to collide with it and collect it. He sent Sanchez. Just about 5 minutes left. Distributed short. This is Stone now. Jared Stone trying to make something out of it. It's lost though. They're up for anyone to pick up. Neither team really has control over it now. This is Wisniewski trying to collect it. Wisniewski loses the way. Schulte trying to keep it inbounds. And Wesleyan will have a throw in now. Switching the play with that little flat ball though, has his teammate trying to come back for it, nearly picked up though. And out of bounds, it's shielded out. Wilder has it. Wilder drew a foul though, it's gonna be a free kick. Referee trying to play advantage, but it bounced out of bounds though. Foul against David Chavez. Gilliam standing over a free kick almost right at midfield. Has 3 minutes to get a goal here in regular time. Bouncing right at the top of the box, nearly gets headed away. Still alive for Westminster. Udinyewe trying to bring it down. Pacheco's there to pick it up. A nice little slide tackle somewhere in there. Schulte gets a head on it all the way out to here. Wisniewski. Wisniewski back to Schulte. Schulte on the shot, gets carried away, out of bounds. Quarter kick coming up.
That was a very good chance there for Schulte. Wisniewski with a clever pass to find him. Westminster has had all of the control in these past 10, 15 minutes. Let's see if he can accumulate in the goal before stoppage time or added time, extra time. That's what it's really called. So we'll see if Westminster has what it takes to finally put the ball in the net. They've had all the control for the last 10 to 15 minutes.
Rua to play the outswinging corner in over the head of every single player in the box, picked up by David Chavez on the far side. Nene with a nice little tackle, keeps it inbounds. Here's Freddie Nene to Wisniewski. Gets touched out of bounds. Another Westminster corner kick coming up. 2 minutes to go here in the 88th minute. To collect it again, this time will be an in-swinging ball. Six Blue Jays in the box. Rua to the back post. Udinyewe is there. Still fighting for it. Wisniewski's also trying to fight for it to keep it in bounds. One play that was by Pacheco to have it. Pacheco to Saldana. No, out of bounds. Taken quickly by Gilliams. Far for Udinyewe. Big collision right there. Foul being called against Joao Vieira. Just about 30 yards out from goal. Clock is still ticking, about 70 seconds still to play in this regular time. Wisniewski's there. Who is there. Schulte's also there. Wisniewski will play it into the center of the bar. Punched away by Sanchez. Joe Wilder picking it up. Playing it all the way down the left-hand flank. Joshua Udinyewe. Chavez there to parry away his cross. Throw in now as there's 30 seconds on the clock. Francois Roux at the top of the box here. He'll lay it off for Udinyewe again. He'll have to go along the back line here for Westminster. Picked up by Saldana. Saldana trying to use his pace. Here comes Chase Boat to clear it away. No, Saldana. Nearly getting fouled from behind. Bouncing out of bounds. Referee still yet to make any sort of decision. Points to the spot. Called a penalty, but still wants to have a word with his assistant referee on the far side.
3/10 of a second left on a clock and a penalty for Francisco Javier Saldana. And I mean, he was tripped from behind. It was an end of the game moment. All Saldana had to do was beat Vaught.
Certainly a smart foul, though. He beat Chase Boak, he beat the entire back line.
It was the last ditch effort.
You're a defender in that situation, there's nothing you can do but make that foul, but he may have gotten a foot on that ball, and that's what I think the two referees are debating on that far side.
It's either you give up the chance at a penalty and you give Vogt one more chance to save it, or you just give up the freebie goal and you make the right choice there. And now we'll see if Francisco Javier Saldana can win the game with less than a second left. Will, my goodness, what drama to end this one.
I believe the foul came with still about 10 seconds left. Uncertainty that followed afterwards didn't stop the clock till 3/10 of a second. As there's still uncertainty from Westminster. It's going to be Francisco Javier Saldana standing over. He had a goal in the first half.
They're going to put 6 seconds on the clock. Let's see if Vogt can be a hero and give Westminster a chance to win the game in extra time, because they were the superior team for the final 20 minutes, and it wasn't even particularly close in my mind.
Saldana, though. Really has the ball in his court. After much deliberation, it seems we're finally getting to the penalty kick. Whistle blown. Saldana off the bar. Still alive on the rebound. Picked up by Chase Boat. Time expires here. Rue headed to extra time. What a non-finish there here at Mueller Stadium. Saldana being consoled by his teammates because they know there's still extra time, and they know they still need his head and his feet fully in this game.
A chance to win it, a chance to be the hero, and instead you become the GOAT. But a chance to redeem yourself in extra time.
We're going to take a quick break when we come back. Start of extra time here from Fulton. As a dramatic end to the second half brings us with more soccer to come. You're listening to the Blue Jays Sports Network here. Don't go anywhere. Westminster after a missed penalty in the final 5 seconds of extra time. Or excuse me, regular time brings us to extra time here. Will Nolte alongside Connor McCann here. Opportunity. A corner actually for Westminster. Again, coming with just within seconds of play restarting. 2 10-minute periods. Golden goal rules. Whoever scores first will be the winner. If nobody scores at the end of the 2 10-minute periods, we'll have penalty kicks on hand. Corner, though, for Westminster. Played in, headed away off the front post. So opportunities with Schulte now. Trying to juggle it. It's going to bounce out of bounds, though, for a goal kick. Francisco Javier Saldana, who created almost by himself a penalty for Iowa Wesleyan, and then just nailing it right off the crossbar. But here comes Westminster with a chance right now. Sanchez thwarting it right into his arms. Uriyewe on the far side finds his brother Philip Uriyewe. Into the box now. Comes off a deflection, still alive there. Uriyewe still picking it up. Nearly getting a shot off, but gets cleared off of him and out of bounds for another goal kick coming. Only 2 minutes into this game, or into this extra time, I should say, and Westminster really just keeping the ball on the Tigers' half of the field.
And that was a big story of the second half, too. Besides the penalty drawn by Saldana at the end of that second half, in the final 20 minutes or so, it was all Westminster pushing the pace, causing problems. It was really just that penalty that they were so fortunate that Saldana had missed, because they deserved to force an extra time. The way they play, they might have even deserved to have taken a lead at one point.
They have a throw in on the far side. Might be a long one. In the hands of Patrick Wisniewski right now. Nearly flicked on again to be cleared away. Saldana's there to try and pick it up. Westminster got there first. Poked out of bounds, though, for Iowa Wesleyan to have a throw in. Just about check in the midfield. Try and play it over the top for Lozada to try and run on. Rua in the midfield. Hits the deck. Wilder's also there to try and pick it up. Rua gets back up and collects it right here. Trying to find Freddie Nene. Uyewe's also there. They kind of run into each other and lose it away. Foul called against Westminster there. Against Philip Uyewe. Coming as we're already 4 minutes here into this extra time period. This first extra time period. Ball being played off the free kick all the way into the box, headed away though. There's Schulte there, finding Nene. Nene playing in behind, trying to cast Sanchez off his line. Wisniewski opted against running for it. Might have believed he was offside. I think a foul was called at midfield though. That was called right as the ball was kicked, so Westminster will have it right at midfield. At the feet of Aaron Gilliams. Gilliams on the free kick. Top of the box. Schulte was also there. This is Heckert now at midfield. A wry pass here ends up out of bounds for another Iowa Wesleyan throw-in. Mecca in the midfield. Again, then try to play it over the top over this Westminster defense.
Iowa Wesleyan's defense or offense right now just consists of trying to fire up a long ball to Saldana, but most of the time they're not able to get it over for him, and it's really caused them to really look stagnant out here on offense.
Here comes this one. David Chavez trying to run onto it. Gilliam's also there. He'll play all the way back to Boat. Playing it by Schulte. Schulte on the far side. The defense getting him right back for Omega. Hecker outside Schulte. Schulte down the wing. Finding Wisniewski running onto it. Patrick Wisniewski. Play it into the box. A shot just wide of the bar. Goal kick coming up for Iowa Wesleyan.
Oh, it came close. It was out of the reach of Sanchez. He gave as much extension as he could, and it was still past the fingertips, but just could not find the back of the net. A little off target, a little wide of the left post.
Still waiting on the goal kick. So just about 3.5 minutes of play here in this first extra time period. A foul called right in the midfield against Freddie Nene. It's going to be actually referee correcting his mistake. He's going to say it was against Iowa Wesleyan, giving the ball right back to Westminster. Francois, who wants to take the free kick? Got his head on it. Nene is also there. Still in the box before getting cleared away. Schulte ends up with it though for Westminster. Gets poked away from him by Vieira. Out of bounds. Westminster will have a throw in on the very far side. They'll go short. Nearly cleared away again. Rua is there. Heading it back. Nearly caught in a corner there is Schrader. This is Gilliams. Gilliams nearly intercepted there. It's going to come right off of Iowa Wesleyan last. We have a throw in. 2:20 still to play. And the substitution is trying to be made by Iowa Wesleyan. Can't make it though because it's a Westminster throw in. This is David Chavez picking up at the midfield. Could Yewe get there first? Played it all the way back into his own corner. Throw in now for Iowa Wesleyan. Under 2 minutes to play here in this first extra time period. Deep in Westminster territory. With keys in his hands. He'll play it short to Omega, back to Keeves. Keeves dancing around with it, getting past three Westminster defenders. Fighting Saldana nearly in the box, but Saldana just a little too heavy of a touch, ending up in Vogt's hands.
Vogt's had a very, very good game so far. He's been a great presence, I'll say, for Westminster. He hasn't had to do a ton, you know, saving the ball. He did get lucky that penalty kick went over his head and hit the top crossbar, but he's done very well to prevent Iowa Wesleyan from thinking they have a chance to do anything. Almost every time the ball is in the box, he's out there immediately and picking it up. He's done a very good job, especially as a presence, to make sure that Westminster feels that they can do whatever they want on offense in front of them.
Well, we're about 50 seconds left remaining in this first extra time period. Westminster have a throw-in on the far side. Udinyewe has it rolled through his hands. Came up with Iowa Wesleyan last.